हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू दिस लेक्चर ऑन साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी। तो हम कंटिन्यू करने वाले हैं हमारे रिवीजन सीरीज, दिस इज पार्ट 3 ऑफ द लेक्चर। इस लेक्चर में भी हम डिफेंस एंड स्पेस टेक्नोलॉजी के कुछ और करंट अफेयर्स देखते हैं। तो द कंटेंट है हमारे लेक्चर के लिए, द फर्स्ट हम देखते हैं स्पेक्टर आरजी के बारे में, ओके स्पेक्टर आरजी देखते हैं, उसके बाद नेविक के बारे में बात करते हैं, उसके बाद हम देखते हैं सागर मैत्री मिशन, हु सेंट द सागर मैत्री मिशन एंड ऑल, उसके बाद वी विल टॉक अबाउट द प्लूनेट, उसके बाद हम देखते हैं नाग एंटी टैंक गाइडेड मिसाइल के बारे में, नाग एंटी टैंक गाइडेड मिसाइल, उसके बाद हम देखते हैं टियांगोंग 2, व्हाट इज टियांगोंग 2, हु विच कंट्री लॉन्च टियांगोंग 2 एंड ऑल, उसके बाद वी विल सी अबाउट द बाबा कवच, द हाइपरबोला 1, द माइक्रो डॉट्स एंड टेस्ट मिशन। सो दिस इज व्हाट वी विल लुक इन दिस लेक्चर। फर्स्ट स्पेक्टर आरजी, व्हाट इज स्पेक्टर आरजी? सो इट्स अ रशियन जर्मन हाई एनर्जी एस्ट्रोफिजिक्स स्पेस ऑब्जर्वेटरी, दिस इज लॉन्च, इट वॉज लॉन्च रिसेंटली। सो स्पेक्टर आरजी इज ए हाई एनर्जी एस्ट्रोफिजिक्स स्पेस लैबोरेटरी, स्पेस ऑब्जर्वेटरी इनफैक्ट, इट्स ए जॉइंट कोलैबोरेशन ऑफ रशिया एंड जर्मनी। सो जनरली वी विल बी थिंकिंग दैट यू नो रशिया इज अगेंस्ट द यूरोपियन कंट्रीज एंड ऑल, सो देर वोंट बी एनी जॉइंट कोलैबोरेशन, बट दिस इज जॉइंट कोलैबोरेशन ऑफ रशिया एंड जर्मनी। कीप इन माइंड इट्स अ जॉइंट कोलैबोरेशन बिटवीन रशिया एंड जर्मनी, स्पेक्टर के, स्पेक्टर आरजी। सो दिस वॉट इट हैज डन इज इट हैज प्लेस द स्पेस ऑब्जर्वेटरी इन लैग्रेनियन पॉइंट। वॉट इज लैग्रेनियन पॉइंट? देर आर थ्री पॉइंट्स इन द स्पेस, L1, L2, L3. These three are the Lagrangian points. So why these points are special? These points are special because the net gravity on these points is zero. That means, I'll tell you. So in space, we have the gravity of three planetary objects mainly. The first is Sun. The second is Moon. And the third is Earth. So any planet in the Earth, any planet in the space, which has gone from Earth, any planet in the space will be observing the impact of gravity from Sun, Moon and Earth. So these Lagrangian points, what is their specialty is that in those points the net gravity will be zero. That means the sum of the gravity of Sun, Moon and Earth becomes zero, the net gravity will be zero. That means it will not experience any gravity. So that is the use of these points. So any body can be which is placed in these Lagrangian points will not observe any gravity, will not experience any gravity. Okay, that is Lagrangian point. So this Spectre RG is placed in Lagrangian point L2, where the gravitational forces of two large objects, in this case Sun and the Earth, balance out each other. So there is no gravity experienced by the body. This spacecraft is expected to detect galaxy clusters, supermassive black holes, star-forming galaxies, and the presence of plasma. So this will be used to explore the space, in fact. So this will be helpful for us to explore about new planets, the new black holes, new galaxies and all. So the Spectre RG is joint collaboration of Germany and Russia. Next one, NAVIC. So what is NAVIC? As we know, NAVIC is the GPS system of India. It's a positioning system of India. So the NAVIC, so why this was in news? This was in news because ISRO is in talks with the chip manufacturing company Qualcomm. Qualcomm is a processor which is used in the mobile phones. So if we have to use any global positioning system, that is GPS or any other navigation system, our chipset has to give us that support. So here the ISRO is in talks with Qualcomm so that the Qualcomm will give us support for NAVIC. This is to substitute the existing GPS system which we Indians are using currently. GPS belongs to Google, that is America. It's an American positioning system. The navigation with Indian constellation NAVIC, navigation with Indian constellation NAVIC is an independent regional navigation system of India. It is used to provide the position information in the Indian region and 1500 kilometers from the Indian mainland. So this question was already asked in prelims. The range of NAVIC is the whole of Indian territory plus 1500 kilometers around it. That is the range of NAVIC. Now, the range of the GPS is entire Earth. But India do not have all these global ambitions. So India has limited its satellites, you know, for the territory and 1500 kilometers beyond its territory. This constellation will consist of 7 satellites. Constellation will consist of 7 satellites. 3 of these will be geostationary over the Indian Ocean, and 4 will be geosynchronous. So what is this geostationary satellite? So geostationary satellite means its rotating speed will be same that of the earth. That means its relative speed with that of the earth is zero. That means if you see from a point, it will be there at that position only for a long time. Not long time, in fact, it will be there in that position daily. Let's say a satellite is there above an Indian state, Kerala, let's say. So the satellite will be there only in that, over that point only. That means it is rotating with relative velocity zero. That means it is rotating around the earth in the same rotational speed of that of the earth. That is called geostationary. So four will be geosynchronous. So three geostationary, four geosynchronous. So total of seven satellites are there in this NavIC system. So these are appearing at the same point in the sky every time. So geosynchronous means satellites are rotating at a different speed than that of the earth. So that means this geosynchronous will appear at that same time every day. That means, let's say a satellite is appearing at 5 p.m. in Kerala. That means 5 p.m. in Kerala. Just a minute. Satellite is appearing at 5 p.m. in Kerala. So what does that mean? The geostationary means it will be there at 5 p.m., 6 p.m., 7 p.m. at all the time over Kerala. But the geosynchronous, daily only at 5 p.m. you will be able to see that object above Kerala, that is satellite above Kerala, because its speed, its rotating speed is different than that of the earth. Okay, so the NavIC system will be providing different services like the positioning system, the navigation system, and also it provides some restricted services to the Indian Army and other defense forces for the intelligence mainly. Okay, so that is why this NavIC is used. Next one, the Sagar Maitri Mission 2. So what is the Sagar Maitri Mission? The Sagar Maitri Mission is the DRDO mission. So it's a DRDO research ship, INS Sagar Dhwani. INS Sagar Dhwani is the DRDO research ship. It embarks on a Sagar Maitri Mission 2, which is a unique initiative of DRDO. This is mainly to collect data of the Indian Ocean, because oceans are the least explored areas on the entire earth. So DRDO wants to do more research in the North Indian Ocean. So that's why it has launched this. This was launched with the help of Indian Ocean region countries in collaboration with the 8 Indian Ocean region countries in the field of ocean research and development. This is the next area which is going, which will help mankind, the ocean research and development. The next one, Plunet. What is Plunet? Planet plus Moon. Simply is Plunet. Planet plus Moon. So there are a lot of instances wherein which some moons are kicked out of their orbiting path. That is when the planets are formed. So researchers have modeled the formation of exomoons around the giant gas planets. So exomoons are giant gas planets around rotate kar rahe. So it was projected that massive planets would kick moons out of the orbit and send them on their way. Or the researchers believed that angular momentum between the giant exoplanet and moon would allow the moon to essentially escape the gravity of the planet. So iska matlab ye hai ki jab the moon ka angular velocity increase hota hai aur uska different issues hota hai is planet ke sath, so us samay kya hota hai, moon will be kicked out of its orbit. So moon us orbit se the planet will push away, planet push karta hai moon ko, aur moon will rotate create its own orbit. So these exoplanets or the moons which will rotate on their own is called planets. So the remnants of the expelled moon would end up circling its star with an eccentric orbit similar to that of Pluto. So they are similar to that of Pluto. So these are called the rogue moons, in fact, the rogue moons. So that means a planet is there and the moons are rotating around that planet. Something happened. Let's say it has struck with some star, or the angular momentum or the angular velocity of the moon has changed tremendously. So that time the moon will be kicked out of its orbit. जब moon उस orbit से जाता है तो उस समय क्या होता है, उसके main star होते हैं, like let's say sun is the main star for the solar system, for every galaxy it will have its own big star. तो उस समय क्या होता है, that moon will rotate around that star like the Pluto is rotating around the sun. Okay, that is what Plunet means. Next one, Nag anti-tank guided missile. So we have seen already various guided missiles, and Nag is one such. The range of Nag anti-tank guided missile is 500 meters and maximum of 4 kilometers. This is developed by DRDO. It uses an imaging infrared seeker in lock on before launch mode. It is a third generation anti-tank guided missile which has top attack capabilities that can effectively engage and destroy all known enemy tanks during day and night. Okay, this is an anti-tank guided missile. Tiangong 2, this is a space station launched by China. It is part of China's plan to establish a manned space mission by 2022. Manned space mission by 2022 is the target of China. It is placed 380 kilometers above the Earth. So the Chinese astronauts are going there and doing research in this space station of China, which is placed 380 kilometers above Earth. And the space station name is Tiangong 2. Next one, the Baba Kavach. The Baba Kavach is the lightest and the most effective indigenously built bulletproof jacket. This is built by the Ordnance Factory. So the Ordnance Factory board got approval for this Baba Kavach, which is a bulletproof jacket. Next, Hyperbola 1. What is the Hyperbola 1? It is the first commercial rocket of China launched by iSpace, which is a Chinese startup. So the Chinese, you know, private agencies also have entered into the launching arena of this space, the rocket launching arena into the space. So this iSpace, which is a Chinese startup, has launched a commercial rocket called Hyperbola 1. It is carrying the CAS-7B CubeSat. It is a micro satellite. It was developed by Beijing Institute of Technology. It is used for radio mission. So Hyperbola 1 is a commercial rocket launched by Chinese, which is a Chinese private company, iSpace. It's a startup of China. Next, microdots. Basically, what are microdots? The microdots is typically is spraying of small particles, so which are so unique that we can read them only using microscope. They are very small. I'll show you that. So this is how microdots appear. So as you can see, these are the microdots. So when you see in a microscope, they can be read like this. So why this was in use? The microdots was in use because the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways has issued a draft notification amending Central Motor Vehicles Rules, allowing motor vehicles and their parts, components, assemblies, sub-assemblies to be affixed with the permanent and nearly invisible microdots. That means all the parts will be having these microdots. So the manufacturing, the car manufacturing companies will spray these microdots so that the vehicles can be identified when something is theft. So security can be increased. It will help us to check the theft of vehicles and also the use of fake spare parts. So a lot of times what we will be seeing in the market is fake spare parts. So by using these microdots, we can identify the fake spare parts, and also if there is any theft that has taken place, we can identify the vehicles also very easily using these microdots. Okay, this is that the microdots. So microdots, simply remember, these are small dots sprayed on the vehicles, and the Ministry of Transport and Highways have given permission for spraying these microdots. Next one, TESS mission. The TESS is the mission of NASA. This is used to explore the exoplanets, that means the Earth-like planets in the galaxy. Okay, so this NASA's Transiting Exoplanet Survey satellite TESS has discovered a new planetary system called TESS Object of Interest, TOI-270. So what is TOI-270? It is a new planetary system discovered by TESS. TOI-270 is TESS. Generally, if you see an exam, you know, with the number TOI-270, GU-7674. So these are the numbers given to the planets. So that's a small trick you can use. So the mission will look for planets orbiting the brightest stars in the Earth's sky, led by the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, and it is funded by Google. Okay, this is about the TESS mission. Next is GSLV Mk3. So GSLV Mark 3. The GSLV Mark 3 is developed by ISRO. So this is the geosynchronous satellite launch vehicle Mark 3. It's primarily designed to launch communication satellites in the geostationary orbit. So this is mainly used to launch satellites which have to be placed in the geostationary orbits, because geostationary orbits are at a long distance, about 36,000 kilometers. Okay, so for that we need a powerful rocket. That is GSLV Mark 3. It has 640 ton payload and it can accommodate up to 8,000 kgs. So maximum payload is 8,000 kg for GSLV Mark 3 to low Earth orbit, and 4,000 kg to the जियोस्टेशनरी ऑर्बिट. सो इट कैन कैरी अप टू 4000 केजेस टू जियोस्टेशनरी ऑर्बिट्स. इट इज पावर्ड बाय टू सॉलिड मोटर इंजन्स, अ लिक्विड प्रोपेलेंट कोर स्टेज एंड अ क्रायोजेनिक स्टेज. सो थ्री स्टेजेस फॉर जीएसएलवी: सॉलिड, लिक्विड एंड क्रायोजेनिक. रिमेंबर दिस थ्री स्टेजेस, क्रायोजेनिक. In a separate lecture, we will see in detail what are the geostationary and geosynchronous, what is this cryogenic engine. We will see that in a different lecture. Here, just remember, GSLV Mark III has three stages: solid, liquid and cryogenic. This GSLV Mark III was used to launch satellites, okay, to geostationary orbit. Even the recent Chandrayaan 2 was launched using GSLV Mark III, okay. So Chandrayaan 2, as you all know, it was launched last year in 2019. So this was partly success and partly failure, you can say. The satellite was successful, but the landing on the South Pole failed. It was launched on board the powerful geostationary satellite launch vehicle GSLV Mark III. Okay, so the satellite was placed in precisely in the different orbit. The mission is an important step for India's a larger aim for planetary exploration, a program known as Planetary Science and Exploration, PlanX. Planetary Science and Exploration, PlanX. Now let's revise what we have studied till now. The Spectre RG, it is a joint collaboration between Germany and Russia. It has placed the observatory in Lagrangian point L2. The NAVIC is an Indian constellation system. You know, the range of NAVIC is the Indian territory plus 1500 kilometers around it. It has 7 satellites, 3 geostationary and 4 geosynchronous satellites. And the next is Sagar Maitri Mission 2. This is launched by DRDO. It is mostly used to observe, or you can say do research in the North Indian Ocean. Next is Plunet, planet plus moon, Plunet. So when a moon is kicked out of its own orbit because of the change in angular momentum or various other reasons, then the moon will revolve around that main star, like let's say Pluto. Pluto is considered as a moon of either, you know, Neptune or Saturn once upon a time, but later it was kicked out of its own path and it is rotating around the sun. Okay, so next one is Nag anti-tank guided missile. So it's an anti-tank guided missile of India. It is part of the integrated defense program. Next is Tiangong 2. This Tiangong 2 is a space station of China. It was placed at 360 kilometers above the Earth's surface. So the Chinese astronauts are doing research in this Tiangong 2. Next is Baba Kavach. Baba Kavach is a bulletproof jacket developed by the Ordnance Factory Board. Okay, next is Hyperbola 1. Hyperbola 1 is the rocket launched by a private Chinese firm. We know the US private rocket launching company, the SpaceX, belongs to a private agency. In the same way, the Chinese private company is Hyperbola 1. Micro dots are the small dots sprayed on the vehicles so that the vehicles can be identified easily. So the theft of vehicles can be prevented, and also the fake spare parts can be prevented. This is approved by the Ministry of Road Transport and Highways of India. Next, the test mission, it has observed a new planetary system, CA-270. Okay, that is about the test mission. This mission is of NASA. Okay, that's it in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Thank you.